I will go to learning management system. I will open some of the websites which I am associated with. So Dr. Parveen has posted a link in the chat box. Okay, let me see if there is any question. Okay, so those of you who are using your Android phone, kindly click on it and install the app. And those who are using iPhone, they can go to the App Store and get that app. So that, because just after a few minutes, once I explain it to you, then I will we will show you how to use the app, that particular tool for online assessment also. Now, learning management system, say this is our Ambedkar University Delhi learning management portal. We have two portals available with us. This is our previous one, in which we have many our all the courses, more than 150 courses, they are available on this, and we use it for various purposes, even for feedback, for project work, for on the job training work, as a normal course offering something. These are, and this is our updated, this site is our updated latest version of Moodle, on which I am creating some of the courses, say like on Indian tourism, mental health, because in coronavirus now the mental health is one of a serious issue. This augmented reality, ICT level 1, level 2, these two courses are for the Delhi government teachers, and blockchain in education, developing self-learning materials, etc., etc., these courses. So, and then I want to show you this one here. This website, we have configured it in such a way that it has two instances, English as well as Hindi. So the language pack that can also be installed on your system, so that you can have, if that pack is available. So here, if we select it, it means the students of ours, you can see it now, the things inside it, they will be in Hindi. You can see them accordingly from there. So what is Moodle? This is the official website of Moodle, which you must, I will suggest you two of the websites, moodle.org and moodle.net. Moodle.org, this website is to check all kind of documentation related to its installation or something. It's a good website, those of you, for you to learn about how to use Moodle. Say, manage your course, how to set up your course, how to add students, track progress, how to add activities, what are the features of the Moodle mobile app, how to manage your website, how to get started, everything is there. The second is downloads. And remember, Moodle is open source. We don't pay anything to anyone. So, and 3.8.2 is the latest version. And Martin Dugiamas is a good friend of mine. Very recently we were talking. In fact, today only on my Facebook page, I had posted a link by Martin that the version 4 is coming next year. And for that, they are asking the community to suggest that how the, and can go back to search, yes, how the Moodle should be. They are asking the teachers. So please, you can go to my Facebook page, and then maybe you can see that link. This is my Facebook page. You can see me with my name, Ramesh Sharma, over there. And it will show you that Moodle link into it. So that's a good thing, that it will allow you that how you can means you would want the Moodle to be in the future. So the good thing about it is that it is available on various platforms. You can install Moodle on your pen drive, USB drive. You can install Moodle on your laptop. You can install it on your desktop, on your mobile phone as mobile app. So many platforms are available wherever, and its mobile app works wonderfully. It allows you to access your material offline also when you don't have the internet connection. Once your students, they download the app, they browse your course, and after that, if they don't have the internet, they can still browse, except the streaming media like videos. For that, definitely David. But the text, they can access it even remaining offline. So this moodle.org, please. And second is this moodle.net. This is a platform for you to learn from others or to help others to you know, how to manage Moodle for that. So if you have any questions, you can come here. If you want to tell others about your knowledge, you can also join them for their work, like that way. It has so many of the information, and you can download the source code if you know the programming and modify. You can see here all these libraries, shared products, archived products, and everything is there. So you can that's why it is called as open source, because it gives you the code on how you can use it from there. So now, how do we use Moodle? Let me show it to you. Say I will go to lms.aud. Okay, I will log in to my account. So this is the interface for my account, and we go to site administration, or I go to list of my courses, and this is the area. It depends on your role that how you can make it. At present, I am in my manager role, but we can switch our role to various other capacities like manager, course creator, teacher, and like that. So when you have that administration, like the administrator role is like the vice chancellor of the university, very powerful. They can manage everything within that system. The second next powerful role is the role of the manager. You can consider this role as the registrar of the university. Registrar is also very senior position, very serious position, very important position, like that. Not that much powerful as vice chancellor is, but still very powerful. So can do many things. Course creator, you can create a course and you can manage all the activities. So these are the roles in decreasing order of authentication of power, what you can do within that course. So that way we can you know, see that how you are asking, you are managing your users on your website. So here you add a, by clicking, going to the course menu. The two thing important for you here: handling the users and handling the courses. They are the main things for you. So you add a new, you click on add a new course, and here you give the full name, like introduction to biology, and a short name. Short name is needed for this. This is called as navigation. Whatever name you will give, it will be appearing here in the navigation path. So that's why you should try to keep it short. Like I can write bio, or at least biology to make it distinction, but not that full name. And then I need to tell that where I will be putting this. This is called as category. Category, you can think of it like say Almira, and in Almira you have various shelves. So one shelf is like undergraduate, all these things will go there. Another shelf is like postgraduate, you put the things there. So, and it depends on you. You can create as many categories as you think the university is offering. So it will go there. Course visibility, whether it should be visible to the students or hidden to the students when you are creating it, depending what is the start date, what is the end date. That is the power of it. You don't need to do it manually. You can tell the computer that the course will start on 7th April at say 1 a.m. and it will close at 3 a.m. on 27th April next year automatically. Before that you can't see, after that you can't see. So that way it is highly secure. Here comes a little bit the course summary, like this course deals with and whatever you want to put it there. And here is the course image, any image which you would like to come in your course. Say for example, if I can add some image which will fit this course, so I will add it here. The image has come. Now this is these two three things are important here. One is the course format. Moodle allows us to organize our course in four ways. The last two, topic and weekly format, they are nearly same. Like if I'm teaching say parts of a flowering plant, so I can have it in weekly format. In week one we will study stem, week two root, week three fruit, week four flower, like that. Or topics: root, stem, flower, leaf, but otherwise they are the in a way similar structure. Then single activity format. Suppose you are creating a course on coronavirus and you have developed 10 videos. First, short videos. First, you told that what is a virus. Second, what is coronavirus. Third, what are various types of viruses. Fourth, from where this coronavirus originated. The fifth, next is what is being done in Nepal to control this coronavirus, like that. And you have created only the videos for your course. In that case, you use it as a single activity, that will be better, because then it will arrange them in a sequence manner. And when the student goes through the one, it will open the next one, and next one, and next one, and like that. Social format is something like where you have it in a discussion format way, that there is one question, the students, they contribute to that, they have the discussion on it, and everything is visible from there, and that you can go ahead with that. This is to increase or decrease the number of sections. And here, if you want to show them all on one page or one section on one page, it is your choice. So this is the formatting. How does this course will open? So by normally we keep it. This is good for you to understand file upload. It depends on, in our university, we have a lot of space, so we can allow students to upload even up to 500 MB. But it is always good to keep it a little low, like say like 2 MB or at the most 5 MB. The reason being, if you allow the students, they will upload anything and then your server space may start filling up very fast. So keep it in that way, that this, at least the students, they also need that bandwidth to upload it on the servers. And then completion tracking is very good if you want to understand the learning of the students. The learning analytics purpose, you can make it no, you can make it yes, and that way the rest are the okay. So you can click on save and display and your course will be created. So this is the course, introduction to biology. Let's see how at present here it is asking us, there are no students into it. How do we enroll students? Enroll the students in your course. First, they need to exist in the database. So the first step here is to put them, to add them into our database. Once these students are in database, then we can enroll them in various courses. So you need to add the students. We will show how to add, but first how to enroll. So you click on enroll students. Is there any suggestions on this side of PPT? I could not read it. So here the selection, the role, you can add any person in this course as either as a manager, as a teacher, non-editing teacher, or as a student. By default, it is thinking that we will add students, so the role is here student. And then you can search some students, say like here I can, from here I can add anyone. I can add any student into it, and simply if there are more, okay, otherwise I will click on enroll users. And now as you can see, there is one participant. Here is that participant. And I can see the participant has come that way. And now I can proceed for course content. I can click this way similarly. And the process which I have showed you is to add one student at one time. But you can upload cohort, a whole group of students. Suppose you have 5,000 students and you want to add them in one go. That is added as cohort. So you upload the cohort and then select them in your course. So now this is the draft structure of the course. But first, let's see how that course is looking like. Here is the course, Introduction to Biology, the photograph which we uploaded. And when we go to our dashboard or there, depending on the what kind of settings you have done, it will display the information about that course. So you click on it and you come inside your course. Now this is that topics format. I can simply convert it I can type it anything. For making changes into our course, we need to click on this gear icon in the upper right corner. And this is called as course management. You can see you can take a backup of the course, you can restore a course, you can import it for thing, and you can do other things from the more course management and about the users. And you can track, you can have the grade book set up for examination purposes because it is fully automated. Most of the activities we can make it in such a way that the software will take care of everything. So we need to turn editing on. At present, you see it is all plain, but now you will see these other things like pencil ka icon aa gaya, add an activity aa gaya idhar, ye char muha wala sign aa gaya. This is to, now it is very easy. We can rename them. Say here I will study about root. Here I will study about stem. You just type it and press enter. Leaf, flower, like that. Just simply rename it. And then you think that okay, the leaf should go up, so you can rearrange them. And that way you can just simply drag and drop and it will change its position. That's super easy. Now here comes the real power of it, to add an activity or a resource. So these are the activities. You can see there are many things which we have activated on our Moodle platform, and here are the resources which we can add. So I will show it to you very shortly. First, I think now, okay, let me see some, if there are some questions. If there is any suggestion for the site of PPT presentation slide, you can see. So, okay. What we will do now, I will continue with it. But before that, no, I will stop my screen. In the meantime, those of you who have been using Moodle, if you have any questions, you can keep your questions ready. Otherwise, I want to request Dr. Parveen Sharma to share his screen and let us have to look on the result of an online assessment activity. Otherwise, now I will continue with the Moodle. Okay, here are we for our Moodle course which we created prior. And as you know that now in any in Moodle we can add these many things. In your, it depends on your instance that what you can have. For example, here in our case we have something, few things extra than the normal Moodle, like this custom certificate. This is an extra plugin which we can add to our Moodle so that once the course is completed by a particular student, this custom certificate will generate a certificate as a PDF and the students can download it. Similarly, here you can see Hot Potato Quiz is a plugin for making interactive quiz. There are 5-6 types of quiz which we can create using Hot Potato. And then there is this interactive content item H5P, which is open source, and we can use it. In fact, on our Moodle, we had Turnitin plugin also to check plagiarism, and just now we are having Urkund also, Urkund, Urkund, which is another software for plagiarism detection there. And this questionnaire, this is another plugin questionnaire which we have added to make the questions a type to conduct an online examination for the students. So these are the activities where the students, they have to interact. And this big blue button, it is an open source web conferencing tool in real time to talk to the students. Like now we are using WebEx. You must have heard about Zoom. There is Skype. Similarly, there is big blue button, which is open source in nature. And nowadays, even the MoodleCloud.com, the company, it has integrated this big blue button by default. So you can anytime by installing it here as in plugin, it gives you advantage that you can schedule your class and then you can save the recording there within your class area. In MoodleCloud.com, you can schedule your class, but it won't save the recording from there. So let me first go with these resources. They are quite simple. For example, if you are using a URL, you want to tell your students about some URL. So you go, and URL means any website, external website, which you want to give. So here, suppose I will give you the name as Nepal Open University, and the URL, I will search for Nepal Open University. The website will come out here, and I will copy the link. We'll go back here, paste it, and then if I want to say something, appearance means how it will look, how will it appear, automatic or in a open in a new site or in a pop-up and or in embedding there. So you can make it like open anywhere and these settings, and then save and display. So how it will look like, say you go to your course, and here is this. From the icon you can see that this is a web page. So you click on it and it will take you to the that site of the URL where that was indicated into it. So that is a URL. Next, the we can add page. So you click on page. Okay, someone is asking how to access Urkund or Turnitin. You need to have two things for that. One, the plugin here. You can install the plugin. Actually, the administrator of your website, they can install the plugin. Let me show it to you from where we do it. For that, you need to go to site administration. And in site administration here, you see there are plugins. And the plugins overview means what you have. And if you want to install a new plugin, you have to click on install new plugin. And then from here, you can see how to manage and antivirus plugins are there. Then you can make an authentication. So what, and then what you can do is that, if you remember, I showed it to you, the various, the site of Moodle.org. And here you can search for plugins. So what kind of plugin you would like to search, you can check it from there. Say if you want to search for Turnitin, and then you from there you can search the, you need to install the plugins from there, and once you have added the plugin, then you need to add it, and then it will be visible in your course area. So that way means there is an API for that, but you need to have the subscription, means install the software on your server. So on one hand you have your Moodle, on one hand your software like Ukund or Turnitin on your server, and through API you join them, and the plugin acts as a bridge between these two. So those kind of plugins which are available, you can show them. Like here you can see all these plugins activity, it shows you here around, there are so many are available, you can check for their updates, and there are some extra, you can add them, you can enable them, you can uninstall them. If you find anything which is not okay for you, which is something, assignment, feedback, book, custom certificate, about images, about databases, it's a about this hot potato, etc. So long list. So that way you need to configure them for your course. What is the question? My sound is uninterrupted. Okay, maybe sometimes the internet is slow, so in that sometimes it happens. Let me come back to our course. So here was how. Now, how to add page. So this is the page. I will add. Page is a sort of an information on which the students will be reading something, and the page can hold anything. So I can write here like flower, and description, it's a sort of a summary which you, or means you can, or you can avoid, it is not compulsory, but here comes the text. So you can simply say like you can copy paste some text like that, it has come. And if you think that you want to add some image from here, you can add by inserting image. You click here, browse repository, you can upload a file, you can select, and you can add some file into your course and upload it. The file has come here, and you can save this image. So look, the image has come. And similarly, you can make anything as a hyperlink by making the hyperlink here and creating a link for that, and that will become as a hyperlink. You bring it and it will take you to that particular website. There is one interesting thing here is to create, like Dr. Parveen showed you podcast. The Moodle also allows you to create postcards. Here is this microphone button. You simply click on it to record your RTC. Oh, it is saying that my RTC, because I think I'm running two, three applications. So I need to click something there. But you can try it from there, and you can add something extra from there, and then you click on it and save and display. So this is the page, how it will look like. But in addition to that, we can add a video to our course. For example, let me say close this one and go here. So I'll go on site home, and here is the test course. I'll click on turn editing on and say I want to add an activity, and here is the label. The label is a very good property here. It allows us to see the things as they are exactly on the screen. So what I can do here, suppose I want to show some video. PhotoSynthesis to the students, and I find a video. Suppose I find this video as a very good, useful for my work. And here is the share button. I click on share. This is the URL for my video, but I will take the embedding code. This is the embedding code. I will copy this. I can fix the time also, that at what time it should start. This function is good when you suppose you have copied a TED talk, which is around 1 hour long, but the material reference which you want to show comes at 25 minutes later. So you can make it as at what time the video should start on in your page. You are not cutting any video, the video will remain the same. But on your page, it will start from that point where it has been mentioned here. So you copy it, then you can close it, and you come here, you find the HTML code for it, and you copy as the HTML editor, you update the page, and then the video comes, and you can save and return. Now there is a difference. Now this, if you use the label, it will be directly visible here as such, and you can click on it to find that it works. So that way it works. The difference between now these two functions is a different one, that if you put anything into the page, I can put this video into the page also. Let me show it to you. I will create a page now, and here is the page. I can say here is a page on plant, and here is my details. I will add it, I'll click on it, I will update it. You can see the video has come here again, and I'll say, so let me go back. Now see, there are these two things. This I created using label, it is directly visible, but here is a page. Page is like as a page in the book. Say for example, this is a book and these are the pages. It is something similar, and to see it, I will click on the page and then it would open, and here I can see. So I can add anything, my text, my audio, my video, anything multimedia in a page. That way it can go. Then another interesting activity and resource which we can add to our course, which I use quite a lot, the upper three: a book, a file, and a folder. So let me first make the explain you what is a file. A file is any kind of document which we can add to our course. For example, if I'm adding a course, I click on it, adding a file. So it is telling me, say like I am adding something related to plant, and here it is asking me, you can drag drop files. Files means more than one files here. I can simply go and to my documents and say I have this PDF file with me. I'll bring it and drag and drop. But let me add one more, so that I can explain it to you. And here is, this time I am adding a Word document. So you can see there are two files, and let us save and return to our course. See, here it is showing only one, the PDF one. MS Word is not visible. So that is the difference. File means you can upload many files, but only one file which you add the first will become the primary file, and all other files later on, they will be treated as secondary files. So if you want to change it, then you need to change their property to make them primary file, which should be visible here. In that case, it is always better to, if you want to show them multiple files, create a folder. So you add create a folder. You give the name here, a folder like plant, and then here is the folder, and within one folder you can have subfolders. Say like for question papers, the main folder name is question paper, then one folder for 2019, another folder for 2018, third folder for 2017, and like that, so many folders. And here you can now again bring, so here is your MS Word, I added that. Now let me add PDF, and here is my PDF, and I added them. Let me just save. So you can see here the folder is there, and if I click on plant, it will show me all the files which I have added there. So that way I can either click on a single one and I can download the folder as well. Remember that if you click on it, it will be downloaded. It won't open there because the software is at the, if you have to display something there on the screen, it is better to create it as a page in which the text is there, and that can be displayed directly on the mobile screen of the students as well. So that way. Then comes the book feature. This I like this book feature very much. This is a book, something like a book is this one book, but here if I have a PDF of this book and I upload it, it will become file, because file is one document. But here it is a clickable page by page file. So I click on, say I name this resource as plant, and then its appearance, how it will look like, activity completion, and simply I will click and save it. Now it is asking me to add chapters into my book. So my first chapter is STEM, and its content, all the plants have a stem. And then if you want, you can add image. You can simply say go back here and you can add some photograph. So I added that, and then you can save changes. So this has become, so this is, and here you can see one. This is my table of contents. Now I will click on plus and a new chapter will be added. So the next chapter is root, and some roots bring food from earth to upper parts of plant, whatever you want to write. Again, you can add all these things. You can make the text bold, you can make the text italics, you can make it a bulleted point, and you can format its heading like that. Way you can change it with so many editing features and save changes. So see, now there are two chapters, and then you can add third chapter, and in third chapter we will have flower, but I want this to be a sub chapter. So if you make it sub chapter, that flowers have pollen grains. Okay, and I'm just taking some text and save changes. So see here, because it is a sub chapter, it has been named as 2.1. If I make it simple, then it will be chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3, like that. And let's go back and see how it looks like. So this is the book. You can see here like a book. You click on this book, and then from here you can click on any content from this side and it will open. And a book can similarly include text, image, audio, video, anything, including a web page, the web URL. And you can navigate either from table of content this side, or here is this forward arrow key, either here or here, or you can, so you click on it and it will take you to the next chapter. Now you can go back, go forward. The navigation from any side is possible. So The advantage of the book is that if you have common information about one topic, it is better to create a book, because then the students, they can navigate it very easily from there. So these are the things which we add as resources for our students. And now let me come to the activities where the students, they have to do something for them. One of the important thing here to be done by them is the discussion forum. So we add a forum. So the difference between a discussion forum and announcement is that announcement is one way. The announcement is by default, it comes in your Moodle course, in the top of the page, in the top of your course. Announcements are for the teacher to make certain announcement related to the teacher, related to the course. That is from teacher to all the students, it goes. And if your system, you have made the configuration in such a way, then a confirmatory email goes, or here in the upper top, the notification area, it will show you as in Facebook, you get that red notification, it comes there. So here, what are functions of STEM? This is the question. Here you can say, please explain in 30 words there, and then standard, if you want the students, they can attach, make some attachment. Otherwise you can, so how many attachments they can make, 1, 2, 3, you can decide. And this is subscription is important. If you make it forced subscription, so whenever anyone, either teacher or students, do anything, an email will go to all the students registered in your course. That is good as a teacher. If you are discussing some important topic and you may feel that student is not coming to the website, then let an email go to them. And similarly, read tracking. Read tracking means it allows you that whether the student, they have seen this post or not. So it is whether optional or off, that can go there. And similarly, you can click on save and display. So this has become, as a teacher, what are the functions of STEM? Please explain in 30 words. And the, when the students, they will see, they will click on add a new discussion topic, and it will come here. And then they can write sport. And here they can write that the STEM sports other parts of plant, whatever you need to think, you can add something, you can allow them. And then you, there is an attachment that can also go, and click on it. So that way it gives you 30 minutes
It's good
to edit it. Otherwise, now the students, then they will go. If you change your role to student, so as a student, when you see it, you click on it, you see, you will see that the student there, and then you can use this reply function, and then type your reply here and save it. So this is the, now you can see it has become a threaded discussion. So the first, and see here, this is little bit inside to the right. So you can, from here you can see that which is related to what. And here is the permanent link. This is very good in case you want to connect some discussion somewhere in the Moodle at some other place. So that way you can link, you can make a link of it. Show parent means which is the parent discussion point, and that if it goes very, very long and you want to see what was the parent point, you click on it and it will bring you to the parent discussion point from there. And that way this is discussion forum. So this is there, and then I have to change my role because this is student role. I'll come back to my normal role. and turn editing on. So it has come. Now there are two important things for us here. One is assignment and another is quiz. Assignment is like your essay type assignment, essay type question. You can add that. So you click on add assignment. It will ask you to add assignment name, say like plant, and here is the discussion. It telling you that please explain in 200 words the process of pollination and upload your assignment. Please don't go into the spelling mistakes. And then if you want to add something, these are the important things. Now the assignment, when it starts accepting, what is the due date, you can change them, you can make them. And particularly in our university, we have conducted the examination as the final examination, online examination. The question is available to you at 10 o'clock, and at 12 o'clock we fix it here and it will close. After that, if I fix it on this date and this particular time, it won't be available. So that way you can do it. Now how the students will submit, you can make them as a file upload, as submission file, or inline text. That way, if it is inline text, then you can tell them that, tell the software that won't accept more than 300 words. That is the limit here for online text. And if they are uploading the files, how many files they can upload, maximum size, at present it is 100 MB, I'll make it 200, and I can accept it file types here, PDF, PPT, Word document, Excel sheet, what I can fix. Then another necessary thing for us to decide is feedback type. As a teacher, how do we provide the feedback? As the feedback comments online or as the feedback file upload. We download the assignment of the student, make our comments on that and upload it back from there. And then submission settings, these grades is important. We need to give that it is the how much that assignment is, say like 10 marks, 20, 50, 30, and what is the minimum grade to pass it. If it is 10, 5 marks there, and this way we come and click save and display. There is some issue with the page, so that way, and you here you can see that the assignment will come. And then the students, they can, it has taken us into that area. So that way it is asking us to type into it. And this is there, can a student note my the teacher in the Moodle, sir? If it is during discussion forum, that can be visible. Otherwise in assignments or quiz, it won't be visible. So that way. Now let us see how we can create an assignment now. And here is the grade book. We see what are the our activities which we have given. And then course total is here. This is for the first assignment. This is for the second assignment. The students, when you give them their marks, the marks will be visible here. The good point here is that you can export that grade sheet as Excel sheet, plain text, XML file, and give it to your university to let them process that. And then here are the letters which you can fix depending on your evaluation process mechanism, that if it is A grade, what is there, A minus, B plus, and you can edit and you can change them from here by making them, and then these will be available. You can make it say 93, 94, and accordingly you can change them to all for there. So this is a very strong, and not only that, you can make it competency based. Competency based means the course in which you can add competency, that whether the students will be able to, analyze, critical analysis, collaborate, those kind of competencies you can define from here, and you need to create and add it into your first there, and the assessment will be based on those competencies in that case. Now, before the time closes, I want to show you quiz also. So for quiz, you click on add quiz and then add. There you can give the name of the quiz, say plant, and then about its timings, when it will be available. And here is an interesting thing about the time limit. If you think that your quiz has 10 minutes, 10 questions, so you can tell the students 15 minutes, give them and save it. So what will happen that this quiz is available from this time to this time. Open this quiz at this time by enabling it and closing this. So here I can close this at 5 o'clock. So now it is 5 o'clock, it will open, 6 o'clock it will close. But within that, once a student starts attempting it, they have to complete it within 15 minutes. So within 1 hour, the quiz will be available. But as soon as you start doing it, if you are not able to answer all your questions within 15 minutes, your quiz will be submitted to the system, whatever the left or there. And here, then if you want to give them some grace period, in this case, because you have enabled them, not there, then you can award the grade. Means out of 10, 5 is the passing grade. Unlimited attempts, or how many attempts you want the students to go for one attempt only, or if you want to make them unlimited, in that case what will be the grade you would like to have? Pehli bar jab kiya tha wo, aakhri bar kiya tha wo, ya average of the marks, ya highest mark, jitne bhi attempt kiye, whatever he gets from there. Layout means how the questions will appear. All the questions on one page, or one question on one page, two question on one page, and like that. Question behavior. This is very important for you. Shuffle within the questions. Keep it yes. So that if 10 students are appearing it, question 1 will be question 3 for someone else, question 5 for someone else. And then A, B, C, D, those four options, they will also be shuffling. Suppose if I create a question that name the capital of Nepal. So for someone it will show Lalitpur, for someone it may show Kathmandu, for someone it may show something else, and like that you can control those functions so that the student, they don't do cheating. Okay, there is some issue with the portal as of now. So in that case, then you can we can create our quiz, and it asks us what kind of, there are many types of quizzes available, multiple choice, matching type, mathematical type of quizzes, etc. Just like Dr. Parveen showed you, there are so many large variety of questions available which you can do. I think, let me see, I have the a ready made quiz available in some of my course. Okay, here is this virus quiz. So you can see no more attempt, because already then attempt has been taken, and the time limit was 15 minutes and submitted 23rd April. Here we can review, and then say this way the question will appear, the answers and the correct answer, the wrong answer it will say. And then from here you can see, and you can provide the feedback, and then the, how much the analysis of the questions, that how many were answered, were incorrect, were correct, or that way you can go ahead by having it. So these are some of the important functions available. Let me just display you some codes, that how our faculty members, they have been making good use of these features of the Moodle. And let me go to the site home and search for a course, say this course. So this is a course on sociological imagination. This is the information, this is name of the teacher, and we will go inside the course. This is the course here, course announcement, get to know each other, learning outcomes, then the file. Here is the web page. Then this is a wiki, learning together to collaboratively work on a particular thing. Then these are the resources. The PDF file has been given, a feedback form for the students about this unit, feedback about first unit, then similarly feedback about second unit, and we have information here. There is the audio message. If you click it, so on the basis of that, this teacher is asking the student that listen to this podcast and then answer the questions here in this assignment. And this is a quiz, disenchantment and its intellectual trajectory. Actually, it is a live course. So the one attempt, the quiz was closed on this day. But from the grade book, you can see all the grades, they are, you know, on the basis of the students, then we can add them. So this way, these are various functions which are available, that we can make use of them in our course. Okay, so let me stop here, and if there are any questions, then we can answer them. Okay, let me. Okay. How can a student, Nayan Kumar is asking, how can a student see the notes made by a teacher on Moodle? There are various ways that a teacher can make notes. You can upload, okay, let me show it to you so that you can get a better idea. Here is the course which I created, and you can see here teacher notes. So you can add as a Word document, or you can make it as a page, and this will be visible if you use your mobile app. So that way your notes will be visible to the students. Okay, and then page, how can add, okay, this I have answered. How to customize Moodle? The Moodle customization can be done by the site administrator, and there are many features into it. Could you explain to develop lesson in Moodle? Yes, lesson is created. You select your either you want to have your lesson as a page, or as a PDF document, or as a book, which I showed to you. You add that, and then that will become a lesson in the Moodle. Means you just need to have your text, your images, your audio, video. You add them. It is always better to use a page, because when you save it, it will become your lesson. And Professor Gangaram Gautam is correct, that it can be customized by the university administration. For that, you need to go to the site administration. Again, let me show you the page. This is the site administration. Here is the site administration. And in this, you see, here comes the front page settings. So whatever I write, say for example, at present, you see in the top, it is written RCSET. Okay, and here it is. So if I write here like my name, Dr. Ramesh Sharma, at present here, so you pay attention to the upper left corner, RCSET, where it is written, it will change with my this name now. So I go back to the bottom and save changes. And see, the name has been changed. So this is front page setting. When the students, they reach your page, they will see all this information. Other than that, you need to be doing with appearance. So logo, you can add the university logo. What are the colors, calendar, blog, navigation, Moodle Docs, etc. All these things, you can add them here. But please remember that as a teacher, you won't be able to customize it. Only the administrator, because they have that flexibility, and that is for security purpose. Otherwise, if it is allowed to all the teachers, there will be so mismatch and the site can go wrong. That's why it is allowed only for the administrator to do that. And you can add so many plugins into it through that to make your Moodle more powerful. Okay, any other question? If you want to learn something, I'm creating a online training program on Moodle, on how to learn Moodle or learning Moodle. When it is completed, then I will send the message, and you can then join that class. It will be an online course on learning Moodle. And through that course, you will be knowing that how, like today, I have given you this in real time, this demonstration, this session. But in that course, then you can go inside and learn from it. Then there is one question, how to customize the interface of Moodle. Okay, that is a good question. That is done through the themes. It is done through themes. You have to select a particular theme for your course. And here is the themes. If you can see, at present in this Moodle, I have three themes. The Boost theme, the Classical theme, and the Moodle Cloud, which is by default. Here is the theme selector, and I need to select the theme. What are available options with me? Say, like you can see, this is the Boost theme. Here, the Moodle will look like this. This is the Classical theme if you use it, or Moodle Cloud. But there is another, university in Malaysia, where I was teaching so far, where there we had Fordson. Let me see if I can show you Fordson theme for Moodle. That also looks quite good. This is that plugin directory. From here you can select the things, and here is the screenshots for that Fordson theme. Your course will appear like this, and this is how the home page would look like. So the answer to your question is that you need to select the right kind of theme for your website. Okay. You can get a copy. Yes, I will post the recording. The recording is being done, and once it is there, I will upload it on YouTube and send the link to Professor Gautam, who can share it with all of you. And if you want to, I'm typing my email ID here. This is my email ID, which I have just typed for everyone who you know. You can write to me. Can we place our own page in the interface? Yes, you can do it. Can we use it for free? No, this question I didn't understand. Can we use it for free of cost? Means what you are using for free of cost? This Moodle Cloud is free of cost, which you can use. Otherwise, there is another website which you can create Moodle free of cost for you, is Genomeo. This is the website which you can use, and here in one course you can add 250 students. This is free website, and it can give you about around here you can see 10 GB disk space, around 1000 active users there, and that you can Dr. Parveen has posted the link. You can click on it and create your own account. You can think of a good catchy name, say like, for example, this is the name for my website, egurukul.com, and here are these courses. This is the name egurukul. Let me paste it here, and maybe Dr. Parveen can also paste a link for his. You can think, you, it can be your name also. Like here, if you see my this Moodle Cloud theme, I can okay, home, and I have created this website with my own name, Ramesh Sharma moodlecloud.com. So it depends on your own choice that how you would like to proceed. Okay, so Kiranji, if you can make your question clear to me, then I can reply about free of cost. If you wanted to know the about the platform, these two platforms, they are free of cost. Otherwise, ask your institution to download the Moodle and install it on university servers. In that case, you won't have any limitation of disk space, number of courses, and so many other things. Thank you, Dr. Rumah. Thank you so much. So, any other questions? Otherwise, I will request Professor Gangaram to conclude. And before we conclude, let me repeat it again. How many of us are present at now? 36. Maybe I can request them that now you can, journal page.
Turn on your video.
You can turn on your video so that we can take a photograph, group photograph for everyone. And on your screen, you will find a setting for thumbnails on your screen. On the top, you will find how to arrange, and there you can select that how the video would be visible.
Video is not currently available. Okay, so how do we set up the gallery view?
Yeah, you go into the view.
View, yes,
or and then you will see the all these our windows, they have been arranged in a different way. And there may be more, so on one page we can have around 30 participants, so you need to go to the page 2 to see rest of our colleagues.
Okay.
I can see some of our friends, they are on page 2. Can you take the photograph with your camera, please?
Yes, sir, I'm taking the screenshots. Some of our friends have not switched on the video, though.
Yeah, I can request Tilak Pandey, I can see Devender Khada, Khadka. See who are there.
Yeah. Yes, yes, I can see the first screen full. Tilak Pandey ji has not started the video though. Others have started. So I've taken the screenshot for the first one.
You all also can take, those who are using it on your laptop, you can use your camera phone and take a photo of the screen. Yeah, this page is good because all are, except Parveen's own photo, everybody is here on this page. I will also save.
With the laptop, I feel looking at the mobile phone.
Yes.
Okay, so friends, you can take pictures. So thank you, Dr. Sarma, for your time and your generosity to help Nepal at this at the time of this crisis. Vice Chancellor of Open University had another meeting, so he had to leave a little earlier. So he has given his warm regards to you and sincere thanks for all your insightful sharing at this moment. And also, can you hear me, Dr. Sarma?
Yes. Yeah, you are visible.
All right. And also, as you mentioned in the beginning, that Trivandrum University is planning not just to make interim an arrangement of online program, but also extended it beyond COVID-19 in a blended mode of education. So we'll be going online for so many courses which are possible in a more kind of blended mode, so that we can provide access to quality higher education to the people who cannot come and join our face-to-face program. So this is not just crisis management initiative, it's more of long-term online or alternative mode of delivering higher education at Trivandrum University. So I think we will, this is just the beginning, we'll stay in touch, and then we'll expect you to collaborate with us in the future as well. And we will, of course, we look forward to receiving your YouTube video kind of self tutorial to install and you know, design courses on the Moodle platform. So yes. We'll continue our communication and collaboration in the future. With that, on behalf of Trivandrum University and also Open University Vice Chancellor, we thank you very much for you and your team for this insightful presentation and the session that you facilitated. Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you. I will just say one last point that I'm not sure that how, because when one of our requirement is also to create our e-lectures and how you right. are recording your lectures. So there are certain screen recording facilities, and we can use mm-hmm. Zoom, we can use Skype, we can use WebEx to record our lesson, in which we can have our photo plus the presentation and save it as a recorded video lecture. So just please let me know that if you would like to learn that how we can record our video lectures, maybe somewhere in next week sometimes when all of you are available, we can have one more session on interactive activities creating through H5P, through script casting here, and if how to create quizzes into the Moodle learning management system, because everything remains within the same system. So with this final word, thank you so much. I also thank you,
and
Professor Sharma and Bhavdaji.
And also in Nepal Open University and in Trivandrum University, we have some experts who use Moodle, who has been using Moodle. So colleagues from Nepal, if you need any additional support and help, we will also be happy to locally run this kind of online session on the use of Moodles. Thank
yes,
you.
Yes.
Thank all
yes.
participants also.
Okay, thank everyone, you. Take care and stay safe. Thank you so much. Namaskar.